Daily Planner applications help you to organize your day more effectively than the likes of to-do list applications. In today's feature, we're going to be taking a look at 5 Daily Planner applications that are rated very highly and helping you to plan your day more effectively than something like a to-do list application. And in some cases, that comes at a higher price. Hello folks, my name is Francesco D'Alessio. I'm very excited to dive into these daily planners. If you're interested in learning more about them in much more detail, you can find all of the reviews that are on Toolfinder linked below, as well as hundreds of other productivity apps if you're in the hunt for some specifics. I'll include all the details below, but let's dive in. Daily planner applications are a really interesting combination between to-do list apps with a spice of calendar and hand-holding abilities in there too. So this can come in the form of literally hand-holding you, guiding you through planning your day, to utilizing more AI-based functions to craft your day using suggestions or auto-scheduling. Now, I've picked 5 out that I think are worth checking out, and the first of those is an app called Motion. Now, Motion, it's not Notion. Motion is an application that uses artificial intelligence to help you plan your day, managing your tasks and calendar, as well as your booking and availability. Now, the application has been out for about 3 years now, and in itself, it's been growing in popularity, but the price is fairly expensive for what it offers. It's currently only available on web, but they're rolling, I'm sure, very soon, rolling this out to desktop and mobile. But the application itself allows you to add tasks to your schedule. Being able to add context to it helps the AI and machine learning systems to reorganize your tasks based on meetings that you add, and vice versa. This helps you to more effectively time block, but it also helps you to coordinate meetings that are best suited to your and the other person's schedule, which means you can utilize their availability function to basically organize a meeting with somebody. Now, Motion has been gaining a lot of traction over the last couple of years because it's sort of like this really clean, all-round looking daily planner tool, but the price is probably one of the most expensive on the market, if not the most expensive task management application. But it naturally offers a free plan to get you going, but then it goes to the more extensive pricing, and they do have team plans that they've recently launched for projects as well. Again, you can check out the full review on Toolfinder linked below as well. Next up is Akiflow. And Akiflow is a daily planner app that combines a really nice calendar with a really nice task list, but it does something slightly different that Motion doesn't do initially, is something called consolidation. Well, Akiflow basically allows you to import stuff from other applications. So if you're thinking ClickUp, Todoist, Notion, Gmail, all of these other experiences that you're capturing tasks across your day, basically brings it into one location with Akiflow. And you're probably wondering, why do this? Why don't I just use one or all of these different applications? Well, the idea is consolidation. So if you use a task app with you and your team, or a project management app like ClickUp, and you don't necessarily want to use it at work, then you might want to have a separate skin for all of your tasks in one base. You're working on multiple projects, could be with clients. Bringing that consolidation into one location can help you to coordinate those tasks better. And it's nice because you can see your tasks and your calendar alongside it really, really neatly. So Akiflow is priced at about $15 per month now. So again, not as expensive a Motion, but definitely much more expensive than apps like Todoist that offer a much more condensed experience. But obviously Akiflow goes that step further with certain processes and systems and workflows and integrations that Todoist doesn't at the moment. Next up is an app that's currently in request access only, but their pricing as well hasn't been announced yet. But once you've got access, it is free in this current beta period. It's called Routine, and it's probably one of the more attractive looking applications out there. It's currently only available on Mac, but I can imagine they'll roll out to more devices as they introduce their pricing plan as well. But Routine is a gorgeously structured application because it allows you to organize your day with tasks, but also allows you to plan your week with your calendar, setting objectives and aligning them to certain types of the day, or aligning them to the week that you are in. It's also got a way of not only capturing tasks, but capturing events and capturing notes as well. So it's sort of like a micro note taker too, allowing you to create these small lists on different things as well. Now, Routine itself has a beautiful feature, which I really like, called Console, which allows you to capture stuff really, really quickly. But again, this one is much more designed for a specific type of person, probably an individual's need, doesn't have as many far-ranging features like Akiflow that consolidate tasks, or AI functions like Motion that allow you to reorganize your calendar. So this one, much more individualized, but a very clean, nice looking application for planning your day. Structured is probably one of the most simplistic out of all of the range we're talking about here. And essentially it's an iOS and Android app that allows you to basically organize your day using time stamps. So much like you would in apps like Sorted 3 and even Stuist, where you add a task at a certain time, it helps you to plan your day using time associated tasks. And this is great for being able to organize what your day looks like, giving a bit of a helping hand to getting that set up. It isn't as pricey as those other applications that we mentioned before, but it's one that a lot of people are leaning towards because it's of its simplistic design and the nature of being able to organize your day as an individual, but not necessarily going into the depths of a calendar task and really intense setup like the ones I talked about before. But an interesting option that we'll be reviewing individually here on the channel. Sunsama is an application that essentially wants you to plan your tasks using a system of planning it across a week, and it also has a calendar too. The application's nice because what it does, it allows you to set limits on your day, like 8 hours, 6 hours of intense time, and then it focuses your task around that across the day, giving you estimations and also not letting you go over that time, giving you a bit of an indication of having to stop work. It also does a slight amount of a consolidation like Akiflow does as well, which helps you to bring all of your tasks from other applications into one base and be able to bring them into your Sunsama. It also has some features like hand-holding that will essentially help you set up and plan your day, and also gives you a breakdown and settle down time in the evening. So almost like you calm down of a routine and just basically evaluate your day and see how you went, which is, again, much more of a mindful approach. Now, much like Motion, it's priced a little bit more expensively, but it's one that gets a lot of credit in the market for its design and its beauty in terms of focusing on mindfulness. So these were all daily planner applications, and they help you to organize your to-do list in a much more supported way, giving you something that might just go further than a to-do list application, but not as far as something like a project management app. If you're looking for any productivity tool, check it out on Toolfinder. I'm sure you'll find one that's suited for you. We've got some in-depth reviews there that will help you make some decisions for that big decision of finding the right one. Anyway, folks, thank you so much for stopping by. I hope you found a daily planner in this video, and I hope that we could go into a bit more detail on all of these and give you an idea. There's probably more, but we'll do another video, I'm sure, exploring them soon. Thank you very much, folks. I'll see you all very soon. Cheerio.